Do you have bobbles with your throttle? In this video, I'm going to show you how you can get better throttle resolution through throttle curves for better altitude control while flying through narrow gaps, and also smoother flying while at cruising altitudes for better cinematic videos. Stay tuned. Similar to how we got better throttle resolution through implementation of throttle scaling in our FPV beginner tips video here, and we adjusted our rates based on our particular flying style in our FPV drone rates video here. And if you missed either of those two videos, you can check out our Learn FPV playlist through the card up above or through the link in the video description below. Today, we're going to adjust the linear relationship between our throttle stick movement and our quadcopter's response by adding expo to a particular point in our flight profile. Let's see how we can do that. As I just mentioned, the default relationship between your throttle stick movement and the quadcopter's response in terms of throttle percent is linear. This is depicted on the left here with the Betaflight throttle curve, and on the right with the OpenTX throttle curve in my Tyrannus X7. But if we want greater resolution and finer or better throttle control around a specific point in our flight profile, we want to change that linear relationship to more of a curve, an exponential curve, hence the phrase adding expo. The throttle position point around which we want better throttle control we'll call an inflection point. And it can be any point along our curve at which you want this better throttle resolution. Now, by better resolution, what I mean is you're able to move your throttle stick rather significantly, which results in much smaller movements in your quadcopter, or making it less sensitive or less twitchy and much smoother around that inflection point. So now we're going to look at how we can actually implement that better throttle control around this inflection point along your throttle curve in both Betaflight and also in your transmitter, which runs OpenTX firmware. For our demonstration purposes, our inflection point is going to be the throttle position at which the quadcopter hovers. However, the same process applies for any point you wish, such as your throttle position at normal altitude when flying through race gates, or your throttle position at cruising altitude for aerial videography. All right, the first thing we're gonna do is find out where our throttle position is at while we're in a hover. And we're gonna do that two ways. One is through the Betaflight OSD, since we've enabled the throttle position indicator in the Betaflight OSD. You'll be able to see that on the screen from the DVR video. And the second way is through our channel number in our Tyrannus. And I'll go ahead and demonstrate how we're gonna do that here shortly. Let's get this thing up in the air. All right, the channel number we're looking for is on the channel monitor page of our model. Just hit page to go to that. And this is the channel monitor page I'm talking about with the numbers. The number we're looking for is in this third column, top row. This number right here is going to change when we increase or decrease our throttle. So we're going to look at what this number is approximately while we've got the quadcopter in a hover. Now, that number is not going to be the same that you see on your Betaflight OSD throttle position indicator, because they're operating off of two different scales. But that's okay, it doesn't matter. So it looks like the channel number value while we're in a hover is about 45. Now that we've got that number 25 from our Betaflight OSD for our stick position when our quadcopter is hovering, we can go ahead and use the PID tuning tab in Betaflight. That's if we don't want to change the position in our stick range at which the quadcopter hovers. Right now it's hovering at 25%. If we wanted to change the stick position to where it's hovering at 50%, or actually moving our inflection point to from 25% to 50%, we can do that through OpenTX, and just in a couple minutes we'll go ahead and demonstrate how to do that. But as long as we're keeping that inflection point at that number 25 to gain better resolution around that inflection point, we can go ahead and use Betaflight through the PID tuning tab. So let's go ahead and do that, and we scroll down here to our throttle graph and our throttle mid and throttle expo. Oh, and by the way, all the steps that we're taking to get better throttle control through the establishment of throttle curves in both Betaflight and also through OpenTX, we've included in our better throttle control checklist, which you can download for free through the link in the video description below. So that number 25 throttle mid is where we put that. It's actually 0.25. And then in order to get better throttle control and higher resolution around that inflection point, we want to add expo, or make this linear relationship more of a curve. Now, normally what you want to do is add probably somewhere between 0.1 and 0.2 expo, depending upon how you like the sticks to feel. For our demonstration purposes, so that you can actually potentially see greater stick movement in the video during our test flight, I'm going to actually put this at 0.5. Watch the graph as I make this change. It goes from linear to more of a curve, an exponential curve, and it flattens out from about here to about here. So in this area, or at approximately 25%, is where we're going to get better throttle control and higher resolution. Whenever you make changes, obviously you want to click save. All right, let's go head outside and see how she flies. We've got our stick position, or inflection point of 25% set in Betaflight with our expo of 0.5. Let's go ahead and give a test flight and see how she flies. And what we're looking for is how much stick play, how much I can move this stick with very little movement from the quadcopter. That will give me higher resolution, higher stick resolution, and better throttle control around that 25% stick position. So I'm gonna pump the stick up and down, and you can see how little movement I've got from the quadcopter when I'm doing this. It's only moving by about an inch up and down when I'm doing this, whereas if we had that linear relationship between the stick movement and the quadcopter's response, it'd be moving a lot more than this. So it appears our expo of 0.5 around that inflection point of 25% took hold, and we've actually got better throttle control around that inflection point, or our hover point of our quadcopter, which gives us better altitude control. Now, before we start messing around in OpenTX, I want to reset this to what it was at its default values of 0.5 and 0. And then we get that linear relationship back as a starting point for when we start making changes through OpenTX. All right, we can accomplish pretty much the same thing just by going into our OpenTX firmware in our Taranis, and in our model menu, page up, and go to curves, which is page 7 of 12. And we want to scroll down to an open curve. And what we're seeing here are 5 dots. These dots represent the stick position as well as the percent throttle. So stick position is on the horizontal axis. Throttle percent is on the vertical axis. Now, remember our Taranis was showing our channel number to be somewhere between 45 and 50. To make the numbers simple, and because in our last test flight with the Betaflight Throttle Expo, it seemed to be fluctuating between 45 and 55. So we're just going to use the number minus 50 for our example. It also makes the math easier. So minus 50 would be here. This is minus 100, this is 50, this is 100. So the scale that we're operating off of here in OpenTX is minus 100 to 100, whereas in Betaflight it was 0 to 100. So minus 50 is here, which is also 25%. The equivalent of 25% in Betaflight. That would be 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%. So right here is our inflection point, and we want to do a little bit of expo around that inflection point. In order to do that, instead of having five numbers, we want to have more than five. And in our case, we want to have 11 points, because when we have 11 points, then each point as we go up the curve is going to be 10 percentage points. So our third point is going to be 20, and our fourth point is going to be 30% throttle equivalent in Betaflight. So let's go ahead and change this to, we just press down. We can name it whatever we want. We're going to make this, press down on enter. We're going to make it 11 points. And you see the number of points increased here. Make it 11 points. Hit enter to make it. And we're going to click smooth. And then we scroll down one more time and it'll highlight each one of the points in succession. Just so. So what we want is we want our third point to be minus 60, our fourth point to be minus 40, and in between those two points is minus 50, which is the equivalent of 25% in Betaflight. So what we want to do is we want to change this minus 60. Instead of a linear relationship, we want this area right here flattened out. So what we're going to do is I'm going to click on this third point, and I'm going to flatten this out. Instead of making it minus 60, I'm going to make it, let's go minus 52. And then this one, we're going to make minus 48. So between those two areas right there is minus 50. And you see that we've got that flattened out. Now what we want to do is we want to make it a little bit smoother. We're going to raise this up. We're going to lower this a little bit just to make this smoother. This is a little bit more work than in Betaflight, but you can actually get very precise with your curve. And then it becomes more linear up top if you want to do that. So basically, in fact, what we can do is we can jump up to our hover point more quickly. So we're going to jump up. If we just give it a little bit of throttle, we're going to jump up to our hover point more quickly. And then we've got more throttle resolution around this area. And then once we increase the throttle from there, it's just going to go linear. So that's how you would accomplish basically the same thing using OpenTX that we did with Betaflight. I'm not going to go ahead and test flight this, because I want to show you a different aspect of it. What I want to show is how we can actually move the point at which our quadcopter hovers in the stick range, or we're moving our inflection point. And to do that, we're going to keep it at 5 points just for this demonstration purposes. So what we want is we want our middle throttle position, instead of 25% to be hover, we want our middle throttle position to be hover. Okay? So because this represents throttle position along the x-axis, and each one of these points does, we're going to go smooth. We want this point here to be minus 100. We want the other end point to be plus 100. We want our middle position to be the channel number, the channel value that we got when we were at hover, which was, let's say, minus 50. So at that point, our inflection point, our hover point, at minus 50, or from our channel number, is going to be in the middle dot of this curve, which is center stick. And then what we want to do is, obviously we don't want our graph to look like this, our throttle curve to go up and then back down as we're increasing the stick. We want to make it this number, or this point, to be more smooth. And remember, we're doing this to get better throttle resolution around the hover point. So we want it to be just slightly lower, let's call it minus 60, and that's minus 50. Then we'll make this one over here minus 40. And then between these three points here, hover point, center stick, below that, and slightly above that, we're going to get good throttle resolution around center stick. And our quadcopter is going to be hovering around center stick. Now once we get past center stick in this 5-point curve, it's dramatically going to increase its thrust, and therefore altitude if you happen to be not pitched forward. So you'll probably want to use more than a 5-point curve if you want to get precise with regards to your stick position and how much throttle percent you're applying and thrust you're applying to the quadcopter. You don't want a big jump from one point to the other as we have here. But for our demonstration purposes, we're only concerned about these 3 points and the fact that we moved our inflection point from from 25% of stick throw to center stick. So we're going to go ahead and do a test flight with this curve and see that we're hovering at center stick and that we've got good throttle resolution around center stick. Keep in mind, you can move this inflection point anywhere on the curve that you want just by placing the value of your inflection point from your Tyrannus at the appropriate position on the curve, and then adjust the rest of your points on your curve appropriately so that it's somewhat of a smooth and precise curve. Now, to get this into our throttle input, we need to back out of here, go to our model, and go to our inputs page, down here to throttle, click and hold enter, edit, and then we're going to go down here. See, right now it's got the linear relationship. We want to include our curve instead of this expo with zero. We want to include custom and THL. All right, there's the curve that we just set up. We're going to get to midpoint. There's our center stick. See the crosshair moving? So we get to center stick, and then around center stick, we can move the stick fairly significantly with very little increase or decrease in their throttle output. Throttle output is minus 50, down here, minus 59, minus 40, and then anything above that, it's going to drastically increase. Let's take her out on a test flight. All right, so now we've got our throttle curve in our Tyrannus, and we've got that minus 50% throttle here at this point, and we've got the expo on either side of it. So what you should see during the flight video is we fairly quickly get up to the hover point, and I ought to be able to pump the throttle fairly significantly around it without much movement in the quadcopter. And that hover point, or our inflection point, is going to be center stick. If I were to go beyond that, beyond this point here, the throttle response of the quadcopter is going to get significant. So we're not going to do that. We're just going to play with the throttle around center stick and show you that the quadcopter's not responding aggressively around our hover point at mid-stick. As you can see, I'm pumping the throttle pretty good, and I'm only getting very fine incremental movements from the quadcopter's response. That means our throttle curve is working as designed. And that's how you use throttle curves in both Betaflight and OpenTX to get better throttle control around an inflection point. And our inflection point happens to be our hover point, but as mentioned earlier, it can be any point along the throttle curve, such as the altitude at which you're going through racing gates or your cruising altitude when performing aerial videography. Make sure and get your better throttle control checklist through the link in the video description below. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. We appreciate your time. We'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.